I'm Nicole. I'm a nurse here at Moreland OB-GYN, and I'm here to tell you about our two glucose tests that we do during pregnancy. These tests measure the pregnant women's reaction to glucose and screen for gestational diabetes, which is a condition when a woman who does not have diabetes ends up with elevated high glucose levels. Having elevated blood sugar during pregnancy can affect your baby and your delivery. Advanced maternal age, your activity level, being overweight, or having a family member with diabetes, all are factors that can contribute to getting gestational diabetes. First, I will explain the 1 hour glucose test, otherwise known as O'Sullivan testing. You will be given a drink, like this, typically at your 24-week prenatal visit. You will be expected to drink the liquid prior to your next visit between 26 and 28 weeks of pregnancy. You need to drink this within 5 minutes, and then you'll have to have your blood drawn 1 hour from that time. What does a drink taste like? It's very sweet, so we recommend drinking it straight from the fridge so it's nice and cold to help control that sweetness. It is recommended to avoid foods or snacks that are high in sugar prior to the test. A normal or negative test result means that you do not have gestational diabetes. However, an abnormal or a positive test result means you're at risk for having gestational diabetes, and we will need you to do the 3 hour glucose test. So how does the 3 hour test work? There are multiple blood draws for the 3 hour glucose test. The first after fasting for 8 to 12 hours. Then you will be given a similar glucose liquid to drink, and blood samples will be taken 1, 2, and 3 hours after completing that drink. Because activity can interfere with the results, you will need to stay in the lab during the duration of the test. So we recommend bringing something to read, a project to work on, something to watch while you are waiting. You may drink plain water during the test. However, no food can be consumed during that time. Bring a snack for after because you may be quite hungry. Based on the results of this test and other criteria that your doctor uses, you will be given a diagnosis. If you are positive after this test, your physician will provide you information and other resources on how to manage your gestational diabetes. We hope this video gave you an overview of the testing performed to check for gestational diabetes. We have additional information on our website, morelandobgyn.com, and if you still want more information, please ask your physician at your next visit. As always, it's our job here at Moreland to lead women to better health.